So the company puts an advert in the local newspaper. So according to this statement, the number of telephone calls received in a randomly selected 2-hour period after newspapers published is 10. So let's just write this down, yeah? So this is just a statement, okay? Again, it's not an average. So according to the statement, for a randomly selected 2-hour period, we can assume that the Poisson distribution, if it was 2.5 calls per hour, would be double, so it'd be 5 calls per hour. Okay, so that's where we begin. Now, test at the 5% level of significance whether or not the mean rate of telephone calls has increased. Now, we're just looking at one, okay? And apparently it seems to be far greater than the average rate, which is 5. This paper seems to have at least got 10. So we can test using the distribution tables the property that x is greater than or equal than 10. Okay, but we also need to state our hypothesis clearly. So before we even do all this, we can even say let the null hypothesis and the alternative hypothesis be represented by the mean rate equaling to 5, or if the mean rate has increased, so it'd be greater than 5. Okay, so this is where we're going at. The reason why it's greater than 5 because we're testing whether then the mean rate of course has increased from let's say 5 to the published statement of 10. So let's check this out. Let's just go have a look what property x greater than equal 10 is. Well, first things first, because we're using tables, it has to be written in the less than equal form. So if this is 10 or greater, we need 9 or less. So this would be 1 minus 9 or less. Now let's go ahead and look at the tables for Poisson 5 and 9. Okay, let's have a look. So yep, so lambda is 5 over here, perfect, and we're looking for x equals 9. Oof, so it's quite close, isn't it? All right, so this is what they got. So we're looking at this. So let's have a look. So it'd be 0.9682. So that's what the property x less than equal 9 equals. So let's 9682. So it'd be 1 minus 9682. So this already, to me, this already looks less than 5%. So I mean, I already know what the statement is. So let's have a look. So we got 0.318. Oh God, that would be a fatal error. 0.318, and this is clearly less than 5%. Now, the whole point of this is that when you want to reject a specific null, we need to test whether the p-value is less than 5%. The p-value is the probability value, so it's this. And yes, it's less. So because it's less, we can comfortably say that there is enough evidence. So we always say that there is enough evidence or sufficient evidence to reject the null hypothesis, to reject HO. So if we can reject HO, this implies that we have to accept that this statement is correct, that there is enough evidence to suggest that the mean rate of telephone calls has increased to 10, or at least has increased. That's true enough. And that's it. So make sure you say this statement plus that there is enough evidence that the mean rate of telephone calls has increased. Saying all of this will nab you 2 marks. If you only say this, you get 1. So please make sure you say both if you want the full marks. Anyway, guys, hope this helps, and I'll see you next time. Ciao.